Mr. Theroux.
So, I got a lot of students that are struggling graphing linear equations, so I want to do some of those examples with you today and make sure that next time it's not an issue. Linear equations, just simple straight lines. Now, of course, it's not quite so simple if you are in Algebra 1 and you're watching this video. So, let's take a look at graphing equations of lines in the most common form of equations that we use, which is called slope-intercept form. All right, so we got slope-intercept form. Now, slope-intercept form is in the form of, that's when you have y by itself. That's the biggie. Almost every time you have an equation where y is alone, you're probably going to be in slope-intercept form, and that is y equals mx plus b. Now, note there's no parentheses in here. So if you have an equation where y is by itself, but there is parentheses in there, you will need to get rid of those before you try and graph it. We really like graphing in this form because when y is alone, you are looking at b, the constant, the number that does not have or is not with the variable. This is your y-intercept. And m, or the number immediately in front of the x, is your slope. So slope is rise over run, and there's also an equation attached to slope, which we're not going to be using today, but it's y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, so slope is rise over run. Your y-axis is your up and down movement, so when you subtract, you'll find your rise and your run value. I like to teach graphing and teach slope as if you're reading a book. So if your slope is positive, you're going to be going up for a positive slope and down for a negative slope. And now this is not an absolute requirement, but again, I think that it just makes it a little bit easier. If you think of slope as reading left to right, then it won't leave any, not leave any doubt that your run is always to the right. So we're going to be graphing some lines, and when this slope is negative, I'm going to go down. When this slope is positive, I'm going to go up. But the bottom number I'm going to hold is a consistent direction to the right. And again, it's not absolutely mandatory, it's just I found it to be easier for when I'm graphing. Okay, so let's just do a couple of examples here that are already set up in terms of y, or y in terms of x. Let's do a blue one here first. Y equals negative x plus, let's say, 7. Okay, well this is crossing, or excuse me, this has a slope of negative 1 over 1. Now, I don't see a fraction there, so why am I writing as 1 over 1? Because a lot of students are nervous with fractions. Because with slope, you do need a rise and a run value. So you need to make that look like a fraction, even if it's not in your problem. And because the slope is negative, and also note, you might not know where the 1 came in the first place, came from. If there's nothing written in front of an x, or any variable for that matter, you always want to assume and know that there is a 1 there. So this negative x, or negative 1x, is going to have a slope where you go down 1 and over 1, always to the right. And your y-intercept is b, which is 7. Now something else to think of in slope-intercept form, when you're graphing, and we're doing these without the help of t-tables, is you always want to do the y-intercept first and the slope second. So this line is going to cross the y-axis at 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And from there, because there's a negative in front of the x, we're going to go down 1 and over 1. So down 1 and over 1, down 1 and over 1. And this repetition is not needed. I'm just trying to make sure my line stays relatively straight. I'm going down 1 and over 1 because of the negative 1, or the slope of negative 1 over 1. So here's my line. Good. Now what if the equation did not already have y by itself? Maybe it was 2y is equal to, let's say, 3x minus 10. Well, this is close to having the y value by itself, but there's still a 2 there, so it's not completely isolated. So what you want to do is divide everything by 2, and get y is equal to 3 over 2x, and negative 10 divided by 2 is negative 5. Now, because I'm running out of space, I'm going to erase all this in a minute as I do the rest of my examples. My slope is in front of the x, always in front of the x. The slope is 3 over 2, not 3 over 2x. So the slope is saying it's positive. See, there's nothing out there, so it's just a big old plus sign that we don't have to write. That means we're going to go up 3 and over 2. And the y-intercept of negative 5 is what we're going to do first. Again, always the last number, the constant, is your y-intercept. Always the number in front of x is slope. You want to do the y-intercept first and then the slope. And you cannot graph a line by just visually looking at the equation unless the y value is already by itself. One more time. So this is crossing at the negative 5, y value of negative 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It does have a slope that is positive 3 over 2. So from this point, not the origin, but from the y-intercept, we're going to go up 3 and over 2 and make a new point. And voila, we have a line. Now, if you were doing a systems of equations, that solution to the systems of equation would be where those two lines cross. We're not, but I'm just thought I'd throw that out there for you. Okay, one more example of a line where the equation has both an x and y value. So how about negative 3y minus 4x equals negative 12. Everything is negative. All right, so this is not going to be graphable, at least not without some scratch work with the way this sits. This equation is almost in standard form, and it would be good to graph this using x and y intercepts, which is what I'm going to do in a minute. But I want to remind you again, or do another example of slope-intercept form, which means the y value has to be by itself. So I'm going to bring the 4x over with addition and get negative 3y equals 4x minus 12. Now, for you algebra students, algebra 1 students, remember, or please note, that I'm not doing negative 12 plus 4 and getting negative 8. And that is because this does not have an x, and this one does. These are not like terms. So I can just show those two terms together on the right-hand side of the equation. I can't actually put them together. Divide everything by negative 3. And we get y is equal to negative 4/3 x plus 4. Now, you may note that this negative here, when I divide everything by negative 3, the negative is on the bottom of the fraction. And now I've written it on the top. Well, that's because it doesn't matter where you write the negative sign. You can put it anywhere you want, as long as there's only one negative sign in the fraction. Okay, so now y is by itself. So I can find the slope, which is in front of the x. And that slope is negative 4/3. And so we're going to go down 4 and over 3. And the y-intercept always is the constant at the end of the question, so b, the y-intercept, is equal to 4. And again, you want to do the y-intercept first and the slope second. And this is going to be a busy graph over here, and so I'll be erasing it in a minute. But I think I can put one more on here. This line crosses the y-axis at 4, so 1, 2, 3, 4. This line has a slope of negative 4/3, so again, rise over run means down, and the bottom should always be to the right, so down 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and over 3, so 1, 2, 3. And we have this line, it looks like, whoa, those are almost the same slope, but they are not. So that is three examples of how you graph lines in slope-intercept form. I got a few minutes left. Okay, let's talk about how do you graph a line when you don't have both an x and a y value? Like, how do you graph the equation x equals 4? It's like there's not even enough there to do. These questions, as math teachers, we kind of hope are the easy ones, but because there's so little going on in the equation, it's almost like they're missed actually more often. X equals 4. There's no x and y. You're not sure what this looks like. Well, if you're graphing lines, just think of a couple of points that have an x coordinate of 4, like 4, 0. All right, so 4, 0. That has an x coordinate of 4. Think up another point that has an x coordinate of 4, like 4, 2. 4, 2. That has an x coordinate of 4. How about 4, 5? 4, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, see, so what I'm doing is I'm coming up with points that all have a coordinate, an x-coordinate of 4, and, you know, maybe I forgot that x equals a number is a vertical line. Maybe I forgot that x equals a number that has a vertical line, has a slope that is undefined. Now, a slope of 0 is not undefined. 0 is a value that actually exists. An undefined slope simply means that doesn't even exist. There is no, there's a rise, but the run value is 0, and you cannot divide by 0. There is no slope. It's undefined. What about if you want to graph the line y equals 2? Well, think up a couple of, let's just use the same grid again. Think up a couple of coordinates that have a y value of 2, like 0, 2, right? When you make out a coordinate, coordinates have the values of x and y, so when you want to make up a point that has a y coordinate of 2, make sure that is the second number. So 0, 2. How about 2, 2? The coordinate of 2, 2 from the origin is 2 up 2. What about 4, 2? 4, 2. So you see, if you've forgotten that y equals a number is a horizontal line, and if you've forgotten that horizontal lines have a slope of 0, then you can just come up with a couple of points or a few points that all have a y coordinate of 2 and just connect the dots and you'll have the right answer anyway. So there's graphing using slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. Do the slope and the y-intercept. Make sure you do the y-intercept first. Reminder of what vertical lines are. X equals a number and they have an undefined slope. And horizontal lines. That's a slope of 0 and it's horizontal, so bada bing, bada boom, there you go. That's graphing lines using slope-intercept. Next video will be for x and y-intercepts. Go do your homework.